Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Stanford Lee Show, the place for songs, stories, musicology, and more. This episode, we're going to talk about House of the Rising Sun. Let's get started. Barrel House. Yeah. Mother, tell your children not to do the things I've done. Live a life of sin and misery in the house of the rising sun. In the house of the rising sun. Take it home. Thank you. You know, you have Las Vegas, but they say New Orleans is the greatest free show on earth. And I've been there a few times, and fortunately, nothing really good nor really bad happened while I was there. I think it was probably a lack of alcohol. However, we did take the cousin out to, you know, kind of heal himself from a relationship he was in, and I just remember something about a good time and us going out and seeing New Orleans for what it is. There's some real history there, and that's what I like about it. I was kind of schooled this week in thinking that I knew what the real version of House of the Rising Sun was. See, I thought that it was just like a folk song that came from some place back in time, and then it got to this British band. And there you go. It's just, you know, the same song except with electric guitars and rock and roll. But no, the song was actually quite different. And it was really just a pub song. It didn't have that kind of ominous minor chord feel to it or the kind of triplet feel that the Animals version has. It was as much of a pub song as anything. I mean, it's that's kind of what I like about it. I actually like both versions a lot now. Yeah, like I said, I've been to New Orleans a few times. For me, it was enjoying the jazz on the streets. People would be out there with band instruments, walking around, playing songs that they've known that were familiar to audiences of that kind of music as well. I had a great time. There's galleries there, there's nightlife, things to see. The story of this song is familiar to me in listening to older music. It's kind of what you would call the prodigal son theme. And it's very classic in this format. It mentions the mother, the father, and then a kind of repentance at the end about, I guess, an admonition to the youth. Hey, don't, you know, do the things I've done and go down this path of, you know, sin and iniquity or whatever. So it's kind of fun like that. And there's a few songs that I like, you know, they're written that way. It's just really good storytelling. You get kind of a history of the person and something I think everybody can identify with, you know, as they're kind of lost in their wild years. So I got a couple versions to share of the song. I'll quit talking and share a little bit about that. There's nothing more New Orleans than a banjo, right? What, this is kind of like the 1960s version of the song. Just a little bit of it. Mother, tell your children not to do the things I've done. live a life of sin and misery in the house of the rising sun. But if we were going to do the lead belly version, what would that be? You know, it'd be like, you know, more like a jump blues thing. There is a house in New Orleans they call the Rising Sun. Been the ruin of many a poor boy, and me, my Lord was one. So let's cut to it. Mother, tell your children not to do the things I've done. Live a life of sin and misery in the house of the rising sun. Something like that. Just playing around a little bit. Thanks, we had a great time, and I'll see you next week on the Stanford Lee Show.